There's a common sight on the streets of Jakarta, trained monkeys who beg for money for their often impoverished handlers. It's a trade that seems harmless enough until you realise that the primates were not long ago swinging free in the jungles of Sumatra. David O'Shea has been examining the monkey business that has animal rights activists up in arms.
It's a new day in the Indonesian capital, and for millions of people struggling to eke out a living here, it's back to the daily grind. In the procession of human commuters, this long-tailed macaque is off to work too. Born wild in the jungles of Sumatra, she's now forced to beg by the side of the road. Her handler, who makes her wear a doll's mask, targets the areas with the worst traffic jams and then waits for passing motorists to give money. There's little reward for effort in this business. So far, only a mandarin.
Tidak ada yang kasih duit.
Mungkin harus bersabar kalau
biasanya begini.
Biasa juga begini. Cuma kan nggak mungkin nggak ngasih semua, pasti ada yang ngasih.
Not far away, another long-tailed macaque is getting ready for work. To get there, Atun and her handlers have to dice with death on these chaotic streets. Atun isn't a roadside beggar, but instead works the neighbourhoods performing for children. She's reluctant to get started though, and needs to be egged on with a yank on the chain.
In Indonesia, the attitude towards animals in general is that humans are both animals. We can do anything with animals we want. Wildlife is there for us to use.
Femke Den Haas is from the Jakarta Animal Aid Network. She's campaigning to have the macaques listed as endangered and to stop them from being used in this way.
Macaques are just like great apes. They're self-aware. They are highly intelligent, they're social. So even, we don't have to only look at the protected status, like are they endangered or not, but just out of ethical reasons, they should not be used on the streets and be going through so much cruelty. They should be living in the wild. The whole Dancing Monkeys performance is a room type of education. It's showing children that it's okay to exploit animals, to beat animals, to put them on chains, and to use them as a toy. And that's basically, they are being used as a puppet. Like, these monkeys are so frightened that they do anything the owner is asking them. And you see them, you see their frustration. Like, sometimes they're suddenly biting themselves. Children think that's funny. They go, ha, look, he's biting himself, you know? Because they just see them as puppets. They never get any education whatsoever about that this is a living being that, you know, used to live in a family and has feelings and nothing.
Today's performance finishes early because a link in the chain has broken and they don't want to risk her escaping.
Dia juga ada bahaya, dia mau
mau lari.
Gigit orang atau apa?
Iya, kalau nggak di rantai ini. Kalau ada anak kecil banyak yang gigit dia.
Kerjanya capek ya?
Capek.
Panas?
Iya panas. Setiap hari kita begini. Panasan. Besok kalau misalkan dapat uang paling 10.000, kita pulang habis. Besoknya begini lagi. Ya tiap hari aja begini.
They earn only a little over a dollar a day, but the boys say they don't have other options. They're both orphans, and this is the only life they know. They've been working with monkeys since they were just 3 years old.
Kita kan tua nggak punya, jadi kita ya nyari uang-uang begini
buat makan,
buat
aja.
Makan kita. Hmm. Sampai kita besar begini juga masih topeng monyet aja. Hmm. Kita buat nyari-nyari uang buat makan, cari 1.000-2.000 ya kan, kita buat makan di sini.
They tell me that Atun is like an old friend.
Kita main kecil berdua gitu, sampai besar begini.
Dan dia sama monyet ini terus?
Iya.
Sama monyet yang sama terus, tidak iya. Pernah ganti-ganti?
Monyetnya nggak pernah ganti-ganti. Tiap kita usaha, ya sama monyetnya ini.
Ini CS kita.
Ini
CS kita.
CS kental ini.
Udah kayak, tidak boleh dilupakan.
Iya. Ibarat keluarga, family. Ini ibu, ini bapak, ini anaknya.
Not all monkeys, though, are as lucky as Atun. Femke Den Haas tells me that the Jakarta Animal Aid Network is desperate to stop street kids using monkeys to beg. And this means stopping those people who prey on the street children by renting them the trained monkeys as begging props.
The children have to pay a certain amount of money each day to the owner of the monkeys. The owner is just this guy that keeps the monkeys under poor conditions next to his house. And this is in different locations in Jakarta. And he rents them out to these poor street children. And if the street children don't come back with him with enough money, or, you know, with a problem with the monkey, or the monkey escaped, or whatever, those street children have a problem.
Hartono is one of the men she's talking about. He's been in the monkey business for 14 years. He keeps them in cages next to his house and rents them out at a day rate. He even has baby monkeys, born here in a cage, although I'm told the survival rate is not good.
Katanya sering meninggal juga, kenapa itu?
Ya udah tua, sakit.
Tapi ya anaknya juga meninggal katanya.
Ya kadang-kadang stres, tahu salah makan, ada yang ngasih makanan, apa namanya. Kadang-kadang nemu bekas baygon, bekas obat nyamuk.
Gitu. Oh mereka ini makan ya, di sembarangan di...
Sembarangan makan, jadi kena obat nyamuk mati.
Hartono buys monkeys which have already been trained by this man, Panjul. I join him at the animal market in East Jakarta. He's on the hunt for new stock. He looks for monkeys which are about 3 to 4 months old because he says they're the easiest to train.
Ini udah lewat. Lewat usia. Kalau yang bawahnya udah lewat usia, udah dewasa, udah susah. Yang ini.
For a country with so many endangered and protected animals, it's incredible that they're all for sale down these side streets.
Macam-macam di sini ya?
Iya, segala ada. Binatang apa di sini ada.
Panjul eventually finds a suitable monkey, but because the vendor didn't want to be filmed making the sale, he only shows me once we've moved away. In 4 months' time, once he's taught him a repertoire of tricks, this monkey will be worth 5 times what he just paid. So now it's off home to start the training. The first thing the new monkey has to learn is to stand like a human. With his hands tied behind his back so he can't climb the chain, he'll be kept like this until his leg muscles develop.
Dengan cara digantung begini kita lakukan seminggu sampai 10 hari biar dia bisa berdiri, jalan seperti manusia. Seminggu sampai 10 hari. Ini tahap awal pelatihan.
Panjul starts them off like this for 2 hours and then gradually increases it to 5, then 10 hours a day.
Kalau udah kelihatan dia kuat, semalam juga kita gantung dia nggak ngapa-ngapa. kuat gitu.
At that point, the chain will be so tight, he'll be standing on tiptoes.
Kakinya nggak sakit kayak gitu. Dia berdiri begitu, dia apa tidak biasa buat monyet kan?
Iya, biasa. Paling pegel, sakit enggak? Pegel.
Hanjul has monkeys at various stages of training. This one has been learning the ropes for a month now. It will take another 3 or 4 months before it's ready to go to work.
Kemarin udah yang diperkenalkan ini. Udah pengenalan ke jenis permainan. Cuman dia masih stres, masih teriak-teriak karena belum lama.
He's currently learning to do a somersault and to salute. Eventually, he'll be as competent as Panjul's smartest monkey. He can be easily distinguished by the boot polish that Panjul has painted on his head. He knows the whole routine and can do all the tricks. He's not frightened of the children. In short, for the man who rents him out for the day, he's a money-making machine.
Terus ada nggak yang komplain? Ini kasihan monyet harus di hutan.
Ada.
Banyak.
Banyak.
Apa? Anda jawab apa?
Ada. Jawab.
Jawabnya?
Ya di kalau di hutan ya parah itu kalau di sini karena lebih jinak.
Tapi kenapa parah di hutan? Itu memang
belum terlatih pak. Belum terlatih.
The long-tailed macaque is not yet listed as an endangered species, even though the Jakarta Animal Aid Network has lobbied for this. Femke den Haas is so frustrated with the lack of progress, she's about to broaden the campaign.
We really wanted to solve this locally. We never wanted to set up a big campaign, but now we are. Now we are at the point of saying, okay, we've tried everything on a local level, it's all empty promises, nothing is changing, more and more monkeys are being used. We now even see baby monkeys, we see mothers with weaning babies on the streets. I mean, it's unacceptable and we do need international pressure to end this.
But for Atun's handlers, this is just the way it's done.
Ada yang marahin katanya kasihan monyet atau tidak?
Iya, ada. Kadang-kadang kita main. Udah gitu ada yang suka ngomong, "Bang, awas bang, monyetnya kasihan, jangan disiksa mulu." Ya emang monyetnya mainnya begini, emang tradisi kita mainnya begini, emang kita mainnya begini.
David O'Shea filming and reporting there. Go to our website to tell us your thoughts on that story and any of tonight's other reports. And there's a link to more information on the Jakarta Animal Aid Network at sbs.com.au/dateline.